Humans make mistakes. Granted, some make bigger mistakes than others, and some make mistakes so big that others have to pay the price. Here we've gathered some of the more fantastic disasters caused by human error, from a bridge that couldn't stay in shape to a bunch of space problems. Get comfy. This is Famous Engineering Disasters. 10. Vasa. Okay, we'll kick this off with something you can have a little laugh at. A Swedish warship named Vasa was ordered built by Gustavus Adolphus, the King of Sweden, as part of a military expansion. So it was designed and built between 1626 and 1628, and boasted things like a 226-foot length and 64 different cannons that could let loose, at minimum, 650 pounds of ammunition from one side of the ship. It was also touted as stable, and in 1628, Sofring Hansen, the guy in charge of supervising the construction, wanted to impress Claes Fleming, a Swedish admiral, and decided to rock the boat. He had 30 men run back and forth to get the ship rolling a bit, but Fleming stopped the demonstration after the men he had made only 3 trips because he was afraid the Vasa would sink. He should have listened to his intuition, because on its maiden voyage, the ship was hit by a gust of wind and pushed far to its port side, allowing water to flow into the lower gun ports and sank just 1,400 yards from where it started. 9. Skylab. This space station was beautiful and had everything that it needed for crews to visit and perform various scientific experiments. It did have a few problems, and it didn't even make it out of the gate intact, which forced crews to perform repairs and save the station. It launched on May 14, 1973, and suffered some pretty substantial damage as it made its way off of Earth. Pretty quickly, the micrometeoroid shield, which also served as a sunshade, tore away, and it took one of the station's main solar panels with it as well. The debris from the shield also kicked back, and to further remove power capabilities, pinned another solar panel against the side of the vehicle, making it impossible to deploy. So, it was left with hardly any power, as well as super susceptible to solar heating, which could have made it unusable. Overall, 3 crewed missions to the station took place, the first of which focused heavily on repairing the damages, but they pulled it off. 8. Bhopal. This tragedy occurred in Bhopal, India in December 1984 and took the lives of 2,259 people almost instantly. It's also estimated that some 8,000 to 11,000 lost their lives in the few weeks following the disaster. Oh, and it caused another 558,125 injuries, of which 3,900 were permanently disabling. Well, what happened? A significant amount of poisonous gas was released at a Union Carbide pesticide plant, a release that could have been averted. Many of the plant's safety systems at the time were malfunctioning, and countless old lines and valves were in pretty bad condition. One tank storing 42 tons of methyl isocyanate became unable to pump, so workers tried to unclog it. Water made its way into the tank and caused a runaway exothermic reaction, causing the tank to leak. Once the pressure inside got bad enough, an emergency relief valve began to release. At least 42 tons of methyl isocyanate was pumped directly into the atmosphere, resulting in what's commonly referred to as the world's worst industrial disaster. Oh, and once a leak was noticed, but before things got too bad, employees decided to go on a tea break and fix the problem later. 7. Columbia. A sad day in America fell on February 1st, 2003, when 7 astronauts lost their lives when their shuttle, the Space Shuttle Columbia, disintegrated upon re-entry. The mission launched on January 16, 2003, and during said launch, a little piece of foam insulation broke free of the craft, hit the left wing, and damaged it pretty badly. Now, when we say a little piece, we mean around a suitcase-sized and this is thought to have punctured a hole around 6 to 10 inches in diameter in the wing's reinforced carbon-carbon panels. Engineers at NASA gave voice to their concerns about the wing on numerous occasions, but were basically blown off by NASA management and the Department of Defense, and it eventually ended in disaster. On its way down, hot atmosphere gases were able to flow in through the hole and critically damage internal wing structure, causing significant instability and a chain of events that would tear apart the entire shuttle. 6. Quinton Shill Rail Disaster. On May 22, 1915, five trains collided close to Gretna Green, a parish in Dumfriesshire, Scotland, just outside of the Quinton Shill signal box. The official loss of life due to the incident was marked down as 227, although four identified children were not included in the count. Now, the Quinton Shill signal box controlled two passing loops, which are basically passing lanes built for, well, passing. Both of the passing loops at Quinton Shill were occupied at the time of the crash, and a passenger train heading north was standing on the southbound main line. Well, then a southbound troop train came along and collided with the passenger train. And a minute later, the wreckage was crashed into by a northbound sleeping car express train. A fire broke out and engulfed the wooden carriages of the troop train, and it quickly spread to all five trains out front of Quinton Shill. Half of the soldiers on board perished, as did nine passengers and three employees of the railway. And the whole mess was found to be the fault of two signalmen who had ignored the rules. They were jailed for a year, and upon their release, they were rehired by the railway. 5. Challenger. There have been two full-scale space shuttle disasters in United States history, the Columbia being one and the Challenger being the other. Not only was the shuttle carrying a civilian school teacher, Krista McAuliffe, but it was carrying a payload specialist and five NASA astronauts. It launched at 11:38 a.m. on January 28, 1986, and just 73 seconds into its flight, it completely broke apart. It was later found that an O-ring in the Challenger's right solid rocket booster, SRB, failed around liftoff because it was extremely cold the morning of January 28th, too cold for the O-ring to handle. This led to the SRB joint being breached, which let pressurized burning gas from inside the rocket to make its way outside and touch the SRB's rear joint attachment hardware and the external fuel tank. This all led to the SRB separating from the aft strut, which attached it to the external tank, and then to the external tank's structural failure. Aerodynamic forces pulled apart the rest of the shuttle. It turns out the O-rings used in the launch weren't tested in conditions under 50 degrees Fahrenheit, and subjecting them to lower temperatures made them more subject to seal failure and less resilient. At the time of the launch, the temperature was 36 degrees. 4. Tacoma Narrows Bridge. Alright, so way back in 1940, a big old suspension bridge was built in Tacoma, Washington, between the city of Kitsap Peninsula and spanned the Tacoma Narrow Strait. It was, at the time, the third longest suspension bridge in the world, although it only had two lanes and was just 39 feet wide. The Tacoma Narrows Bridge was opened on July 1, 1940, and just 4 months later, on November 7th, it collapsed into the water below. The thing is, during construction, the bridge had been noted as having some pretty considerable vertical oscillations, and engineers tried to get the oscillations under control while continuing to build. After it was opened, the oscillations were still apparent, and an engineering professor at the University of Washington, Frederick Burt Farquharson, was hired to try to come up with a solution. Farquharson and his students tried, and their first study ended on November 2nd, 1940, just 5 days before the collapse. winds reached 42 miles per hour on the day of collapse, causing what's known as aeroelastic flutter, which was, in the end, given as the cause of the bridge's failure. 3. Apollo 13. This was the seventh manned Apollo mission, and it was intended to be the third to get to the moon, although some unexpected problems occurred. The flight launched on August 11, 1970, and just 2 days in, just a few minutes after a live TV broadcast, a huge bang was heard inside the shuttle. This was followed by fluctuations in the electrical power on board and random firing of the altitude control thrusters. The crew found that oxygen tank 2 read zero, and James A. Lovell, the commander of the mission, looked out the window and saw that some kind of gas was being vented into space. Over the next 130 minutes, oxygen tank 1 bled out and reduced to zero as well. And during the whole ordeal, all three fuel cells failed. The crew was forced to power up the lunar module as a lifeboat and to shut down the command module, as it had limited battery power and water they needed to save for re-entry. There were other problems throughout the flight due to lack of power, oxygen, and low temperatures, but they made it back to Earth safely after zipping around the moon and using its gravity to give it a boost. The crew landed safely in the South Pacific Ocean after a 6-minute radio blackout. 2. St. Francis Dam. In the early 1920s, Los Angeles figured out that they could probably use a regulating and storage reservoir for the city, so they decided to build a dam to achieve just that. Between 1924 and 1926, the Los Angeles Department of Water and Power designed and built the St. Francis Dam, a curved concrete gravity dam. It had several minor problems in the years following completion, and just a few weeks before it collapsed, a leak appeared, was ignored, doubled in size, and a concrete drain pipe was installed in it. Then, on the morning of March 12, 1928, a new leak appeared and was allowing between 15 and 22 gallons of water through every second. Instead of fixing the leak, it was put on the back burner. And although it was apparent that corrective measures were needed, it was assumed it could be done at a later date. Well, that night at 11:58 p.m., the dam catastrophically failed, and roughly 12.4 billion gallons of water surged downstream and took the lives of an estimated 431 people. We've seen some pretty big failures and disasters so far, and we still have one more to go. But first, we'd like to ask, what are some of the more fantastic engineering failures you know of? Your answers could help us out in the future, so let us know in the comments below. 1. Apollo 1. Apollo 1 was part of NASA's program, which would eventually put men on the moon. But it's an often forgotten piece in the larger puzzle of the program. It was to be Apollo's first crewed mission, although it never got off the ground. During a launch rehearsal test, a fire broke out in the cabin of the command module and burned everything inside. This included Virgil I. Gus Grissom, Ed White, and Roger B. Chaffee, the mission's three pilots. The accident effectively grounded crewed flights for 20 months, until the hazards of the command module could be addressed. Both of the Houses of Congress made committee inquiries to oversee the investigation being done by NASA, and in the end, it was found that the source of the fire was electrical. The fire was able to spread fairly quickly on combustible nylon material, and because the cabin was pressurized and contained a pure oxygen atmosphere, the higher pressure in the cabin played a significant role because it made it impossible to open the plug door hatch, meaning there was no rescuing the trapped pilots. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to give it a like. Subscribe to our channel so you never miss out on any of our informative videos. And be sure to check out this next video we picked out just for you.